After Buck and Chuck recovered at the hospital, they remembered that there was another party involved in their car crash. They went back out into the desert to pick up Tuck, the cow. They brought him into the UTCVM, Large Animal Hospital. Buck and Chuck were driving down a desert road. They're having a good time.
Yeah, buddy! Woo!
Right! Until they meet a roadblock. Buck doesn't see Tuck the cow standing in the road.
Oh, my God!
And tragedy ensues.
Buck?
Chuck comes out of the crash just fine, Buck not so much. Tuck appears okay. Chuck befriends Tuck and convinces her to carry Buck across the desert to California.
Come on. You're gonna live, Buck. Why are you dribbling urine?
Once they get near the city, Buck decides to save his pride. He looks around to make sure nobody sees, kicks Tuck.
Get, cow, get!
And picks Chuck up to carry him the rest of the way to the hospital.
Come on, Chuck. Roll up there.
Where is that Dr. Shrew? That cardiologist is always late. He is never on time for anything.
It's no big deal, though, because it's very common in horses, dogs, and humans.
Mm-hmm. There's only one small problem with that dog. Tuck's a cow.
Oh, well, that does change things. It's not normal in cats and cows.
Cats are stupid. They should all just die.
Okay, well, since Tuck is a cow, let's see, sinus arrhythmia is caused in cows by dehydration, lack of food, etc., those sort of things. So we'll just need normal feeding and we can treat them with some atropine. Dosage is 10 to 20 kgs per 450 kgs.
You meant milligrams, right?
Yes, of course.
Oh, well, that's perfect. Tuck over here is about 1,600 pounds. So that would put about 24 milligrams of atropine.
Okay.
So we should be able to do that. Thank you so much for your help. We're so excited that she's doing going to do this fine.
What up?
What's up? What do you got?
Well, good news, guys. Tuck's going to be just fine.
Oh, praise Jesus.
All right. Well, if you take a look at her ECG right here, to skip all the technical terms, you can just see how it's very uneven and spread out. There's different distributions of what we call the R interval. So this means that she really has a sinus arrhythmia. And the sign of arrhythmia is really caused, in her case, since it's abnormal in cows, it's caused by extended periods of dehydration and lack of food. So spending more than 48 hours in the desert was certainly impeded. I know it's not really your fault, you guys are in pretty dire straits yourself. But anyway, she should be perfectly fine in just a couple of days. We're going to give her some atropine, feed her a really good meal, give her some water and a lot of TLC, and she'll be back to normal in just a couple of days. So if it's okay with you, if we can just keep her here for 2 or 3 days, she should be perfectly fine. We're ready to go home and pass through with you guys.
Sounds great.
Thank you so much.
Just all your help. Oh, no problem. Just come back in 3 days and call me if you have any questions.
We'll do that.
We'll do it.
We'll see you later, Doug. You get better.
Buddy, real soon we'll break you out of here. Real soon.
Tuck recovered nicely thanks to the veterinarians. Buck and Chuck are turning him out to pasture and saying their last goodbyes to their friend. Then Tuck decides he'd like to get a little revenge for being left in the desert.
Swung on, it's the knick-knack, paddy-whack, steel-riding Cadillacs, family off the street.